fears. Y'all should really do the math. If it's based off of sales, y'all should really count the facts. If it's based off of pussy, y'all should really count the ass. If it's based off of money, y'all should really count the cash. Move around with duffel bags like a boy does. Sometimes nothing makes more noise than boys does. Pray us the best movement of all time. Dreams too big to think small time. Focus on the same shit, take over the game shit.
All right, cool. What's up? What's up?
Very confusing.
Right on. So, I guess stream a little more combat. I was listening to Ross, that dude. This is a, definitely the business. The reason this guy makes it in the business is a good product, man. You can't really talk on that in a way. What, dude, what I did is I put the new one, I put his newest song and then over Master Doll. I think they're from like, okay, it's like me and O'Malley. You can tell like a similar look, you know, similar kind of like vibe, like type of like
gene pool, okay?
Gene pool, like tribes. You had tribes, so one person, you took shifts, all right, because someone was gonna try to be a rapist, all right? And then we cracked that fool, all right? Same with them down in South America. We had, like, I don't know, he looks like, he looked kind of like Master Ball. You know what I mean? Like, maybe, like, I am to O'Malley what Russ is to Master Ball. Maybe. I don't know. Yeah. Cool, guys. So here, let me look, let me show you something. All right, why is Blue Guy one of the best? All right. What is it about Blue Guy? Exactly. What is it? That, why am I the best in my own right, in my own life? Why am I the best at these games? Like, why am I Daigo? Why is Daigo Daigo? You know what I mean? Like, I'm the best too. You know? Right. 42 game win streak. Okay. This is Morgan, Dark Soccer's 3. Alright. Oh, shit. Hold up. Alright, look, you can't see right now. Hold up. It'll be worth it. It. Nice melody too. Go. It's like three. Go oh 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 oh. It's like a pyramid. Go oh 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 oh. So it like goes up. It's the same. It's like a. Go oh 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 oh. Go oh oh oh. Actually no, it's more like. Go. Oh 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 oh. Come in. Sure, thank you.
Somebody opened them so they're not as fresh.
Right on. Hell yeah. All right. So thank you. I appreciate that. No problem. Right on. Cool. Right on. Okay. Oh, okay. Right on. Thank you. Right on. So, okay, I identify as like, you know, Captain Destruction or whatever. Like, okay. Why do they want to keep you trapped in your room? Think about it. I'm not the only one. Propaganda. So what is it about Blue Guy? Again, other people get money for playing these games. So, and a lot of them agree that I should be getting paid to play, and they should be getting paid more to play. All right. I'm kind of like Djokovic. I play the right amount on paper. All right. Morgan, Dark Side, I just couple that I wrote down. All right. All right, so forward jump into light kick or medium kick, okay? That's That will combo into standing light kick because we're like brawly, right? That's it. That will combo into standing medium kick, and this could be a block string as well. And then the second one, let's say these three are blocked, okay? So, four jump, they block this one, they block this one, then they block this one. And then there's a slight delay, so it's like a pseudo block string. And then that second standing medium kick lands, okay? That's why you don't go for the crouching, that's why you don't go for the crouching heavy kick afterwards, like Jin says. Because the pseudo block string is that you kind of open them up because they want to do something out of block. And there is like a, like you can advance in guard in this game, so that, but whatever, just fuck with me on this, okay? Which basically means it pushes you back, so you can't really do that, but you can just, whatever, then we can get into that another time. But basically, like, this is like a pseudo block string, so you want to delay this one slightly, just by like a frame or two, you know what I mean? So they feel like they can escape when they can't. And also, even if they block all the way through that, right? Jump back, so regardless of whether they have blocked them or not, you jump back and then you fireball. All right, so that also puts them kind of in the defense, like in another, like, they might get hit by the fireball too. Okay, look, pseudo block string. Makes them feel like they have more room to escape than they really do, so they often let go of block when they shouldn't. Okay. It makes them feel like they're more, it's a false sense of security. Okay. Same thing here. It also has really good spacing, but. Okay, so Scorpion, more combat 9. That one's more about combos and stuff, but the combo usually like hits pretty clean, right? So you can just do the same combo every time. All right, Cartman wins in these games too. All right, Scorp, MK9. So you chain, right? That starts the combo. You catch him with chain, and then you do the launcher by holding back and Y, and then you forward dash, right? And then double jab. They're in a combo, all right? And then you teleport. And then you forward dash, and then you could end it with like having them, like technically it'd be better to end it with like a hard knockdown right in front of you. So like, you know, basically like a sweep, or like triple, like a double jab into sweep or something. But I do triple jab at the end. This is the key. So I end it, this is the key how you end the combo. So I do a triple jab at the end, which means that their character ends up falling. These games are like poker, okay? Their character ends up falling a little further away on the screen. Okay, so ending with triple jab puts the opponent far enough away from you that they feel like they have more freedom than they really do in regards to avoiding your next mix-up or attack, right? And just inherently causes their mind to want to disrespect another chain from Scorpion. Okay, this combo also takes a quarter of their life bar. So if they get hit by the chain all over again, they have now lost half. They could also get hit by a third one out of foolish pride. Okay, so they kind of almost like, I don't know. It's a weird thing because like, you should block, but blocking kind of sucks too. Like, so it's like a Jedi mind trick. So the better part of them feels the urge to do something. Like, and I can kind of delay the chain too. Like I'm surfy with it. Like, but like ultimately it puts them in a position to really like get chained all over again. So to eat chain, right on. So with that said, we want tag ladder. Scorpion Freddy Krueger. I mean, I'm looking for, this is just, we're just practicing, guys. I'm looking forward to playing this game. It's entered in tournament, OG Evo. Like, actually this could be, like, I mean, whatever. Like the OG Evo could be like a bi-weekly even, right? Like, just call it, that's what I mean, like goes out, like it's OG Evo, like other week we play like Marvel 3, like MK9, Bloody Roar, Primal Fury, like you know, Third Strike, whatever, you know, SF4, whatever, like we're feeling like in Santa Cruz, and there'll be a volleyball, the games of caveat, maybe like, and then the players will be cool, maybe like kind of like music like this, like cool lighting, song box will be there, you know what I mean, like whoever's available. Excuse me. I'm a mammal. So it's okay to have like, you're not a male.
Okay.
You can die. You're mortal. All right. You're not immortal. You can die in a fight. You can die in this fight. Totally. Dude, that's like you're not on a mat, dude. That's like you're on concrete. Any person who thinks that like what we're doing, what the warriors, basically the ones who go to war, like, why the fuck would? Okay, I'm just not looking the other way. Like, dude, Russ might be good to get drafted. Think of it that way. That probably won't happen. Like, 'cause that would be ridiculous. But like that's like if Muhammad Ali got drafted, that'd be kind of ridiculous. You know what I mean? Like, but basically, dude. Alright, I'll play a little bit, right? So again, like, this game, there's a lot of money to be made in this game. And in fact, there's a shitload of money to be made in these games. But, like, we don't really... They kind of just, like, the players aren't the ones who really get paid in any sport. Right? Why? Because, like, if you control most of the money in the whole world, in the greater level of the economy, you can buy FGZ. Right? Absolutely, FGC is a humongous global marketplace. So, and then they want to make it seem like it's not kind of like, dude, this like I should be a fucking multi-millionaire based off of my level of skill. Like, that's why I'm all like, it's like, dude, like there's whatever, dude. Like, I have a special touch, right? But we're just practicing, you know. Like, there's no money riding on this. This is just, if anyone wants to hack into the fucking computer, then hack into the computer and, like, whatever. Like, we're just fucking around. Like, I feel like this, like, it's still Russ. I feel like it's got, like, kind of, like, the weekend, a little bit, like, weekend vibes. It's cool. I'm not sure, actually, though. I think it changed. No, it's over us, not too.
Police brutality coming up.
I believe I'm the best scorpion in the world. 4-2 game win streak. I just never went to the tournament. Yeah, like we're basically just having fun. Like, and this makes you better too, like just kind of like being more like free flowing with the combos, like seeing what you can get away with. This game's good as hell. The neutral jump throws people off. Everyone's sleeping on neutral jump in every fucking game. Like, people use it way too sparingly, in a way. Like. Nice. They want to, like, if you're good at these games, that's because you'd be bad at fighting. Like maybe Raleigh, but. Gabe would dig this shit too. Being like, if Freddy's in Kruegar's in this fucking game, there's no way I'm not gonna play Freddy Kruegar. Like, he's actually, people like underestimate how fucking good this game. They don't play him properly. Like, you have to play like way more absurd. Like, but like, come on. He's good at beating the teleporty character. I mean, this team just has matchup coverage for fucking ever. Like, cause like, Freddy beats Kung Lao. All right, that's so crucial. That, dude, Freddy hella counter picks Kung Lao. Like, leave a little health bar for Freddy. Possible comeback. This is big. I my odds just went up a lot. All right. Honest with that, just their block, okay. They have to block the chain, so throw in like that everyone wants. Scorpion's the best character in the game, I think. Suck my balls. Putting like the audio over us, like sports audio over it, is broken.
This will be easy.
Nice. That's a good option for Shane too. I think just be humble with those switches, man. Like before it gets out of hand, like save health bar. Eating like one mix up is not as bad, like, than just like having your character get their ass kicked. His teleport's really good. I don't think so. You can teleport out of the stands. Sauce it. Sauce it. No. Nothing, literally not that. Literally not that. They continue raping people. All right, now we're more and more people are becoming more aware that they're raping people. So if they, there's nothing they can do. This is all narrative that on their end. There's nothing they can do. We're sorry. There's nothing we can do. We're gonna keep raping everyone. Like, no, we can just rape everyone. Cause there's nothing we can do. Like they're two. They're the age of, they're 10. Right? Well, no, there's nothing we can do. We just keep raping you. Like, no, we're so sorry. It's so tragic. Oh yeah, it really sucks. Like, hell no. Dude, it will end up being mute. That's where it's like more like world, becomes like World War III type shit. Like, or like mutiny. Thank you. song. Like, it just like looks cool. Like, sorry. We all wanted to be playing. We all wanted to have fun and like go to Santa Cruz. Like, just like play the fucking game. You know what I mean? Like. Combo I was telling you about, like, it's really easy to do. I made it up myself, like. Who's gonna be the next guy to hold two simultaneous belts? I'm voting Poirier. Going to war is the truth, kind of, like, you know, skating's the truth, like, fighting's the truth, too, like, basically, like, what is the most, like, non-pussy thing you can do, right, like, music school, too, like, getting laid, cool, like, because they're pussies, they make sure everyone else has to be a pussy, like, and then they like rape you over the computer. Like. We want Freddy for this guy. All right. All of the teleporty ass characters. All right. This move like fucks these guys up. That move's just fucking good, like, in general. Oh, yeah, it dropped it. It's just nice that that fucking jab is so clean at the end of that. Like, even if it drops. You know. Fuck. Oh, super armor on that. Freddy's X-ray is great. Dude, this team is awesome. This team could win EVO or OG EVO. Oh, chip. Chip damage. It's such a nice teleport that's safe because it's shit. You couldn't even block it. Chip. Chip. Dude, the chain silences the fucking crowd in the game, dude. I wanted to take a much health part. Okay. Scorpion can always make a comeback, dude. Dude, my odds aren't good. Think of it that way. Alright. Hard knock down. Okay. Cool. That could turn to Jen, you know. Alright, that's big. Alright. In terms of odds, like, that's bad. It's like, that's what I'm saying. It's like 3/4 of a health box. So my chain, alright, x-ray. Alright, not the best time to x-ray, honestly. I wanna get Scorpion out of there. Bad, dude, fuck. Okay, I misclicked the fucking, alright, it's all good. Like, basically, you have to press them, but like, my thumb didn't hit them both at the same time. But no excuses. But yeah, excuse. Freddy fucks these characters up, generally. The teleporting characters. He has this nice moving horizontal hitbox. Right. It dodges like their shit. Wait, this guy's good. That was smart, yeah. Alright. Alright, we need it. Alright, got it. Okay, I could totally win this. Ah, okay, overhead. Beautiful. On it. Beautiful. Right. I blocked low. He went high. Right. Go. You win some, you lose some. Nicely timed on my part. As you see, I sniped the landing really well. Okay. That really got me like traction, right, and momentum. You know what I mean? Like, I think that wristband's the one who needs to be on the bill. You know what I mean? Like, he's got a good block. My Freddy was a problem, I guess. My Freddy was a problem. His life is like a game, dude. Russ, hella feel Russ, dude.
Never get the shit out.
So as you can see, the chain is really cheap.
Okay.
Right after you. That's sick. So you want, that guy had hella momentum, like that's just kind of a showstopper. I like fighting Jax man to man. Like 90s action movie style, you know, Bruce Willis versus like the token black guy. I like accidentally did that, but I'm sick to death of this shit, like how fast this move is. Like, how big Spanner's please are. Sometimes when I'm playing the game, I just start thinking like, oh, I love having a white guy's big boobs. Everyone is created equal. And like, none of this shit of like, certain ethnicities are like more ghetto or certain ethnicities, this, that, and the other. That's not, if we got drafted, we'd all be fighting together like brothers. Thank you. feel that. That's pretty dope. Dude, Cyrax is. Okay. Worth it. Again, do take this game with a grain of salt and a pint of irony. Like, it's we're just practicing for when we're actually playing for money. Good afternoon, dude. That was kind of just like, alright. Dude, I don't really like zoning as much, like, unless it's like with most of the characters. Scorpion, I'll throw in the flame here and there. I'll throw in the power glove here and there with Freddy. But ultimately, what I want is big money. I want hits that will, like, pay off. You know, like, so, I mean, every time you throw a projectile, even, like, the game could become uneven. Oh, okay. No chinks. I don't fuck with chinks. Playing chinks soon is ridiculous. Look, I need to see my wife. My prog impersonation is lit. And playing chinks soon is ridiculous. So, what I'm gonna do here, guys, is I'm gonna go ahead and press main menu. I'm gonna turn the volume down a little bit. So, if anything, what I'm telling you is that Shang-Chun is ridiculous. He can shapeshift into any character, and he just seems to have a clear advantage. So, what I'm saying is I need to see my wife. This is ridiculous. having sex with Savannah would be lit. Unbelievable. This is incredible. This is incredible. They're not gonna win. They win today, right? Like, dude, people are catching on. Big day. So you guys, none of those games are mentioned. But what does mean shit is this. Sorry, the work has already been done. None of those games went shit, but it's still kind of... It's good, like, practice. You know, it doesn't hurt, basically. This is real, though. This is an actual statistic. Dude, I fuck with Russ. This is, like music that, like... to listen to while you play. So that stands. I used to play with a guy online. He's like, my tire was blue in the face after an Alkaline Trio song. And he's like, hey, blue guy. He's like a little older than me. He lived in Seattle. He's like, hey, blue guy. I'm in Redwood City, like, you know, like happy endings of Redwood City. And he was the biggest load I ever blew. Like, blue guy. It was, like, kind of weird, but I, like, kind of fucked with that guy, like, online. Like, I was, like, better than him at Street Fighter. Like, he came pretty good blue guy. He actually just liked, like, socializing with me. He was actually an alright dude. Possessed King. You probably heard of me, like. It is important, too. Not the rank. Ranked it, like, is, I have no, like, take that with a grain of salt and a pint of irony. So as you say, you can see I go about 2-1. I went about 2-1 online. So, about 2-1, a little less. And so, basically, that should make people depressed. right? That means that against the pretty much a lot of, well, I was at least going like even-ish and probably better than that against the majority of the competition, like later, years later. Okay. And that is, that's what I'm saying. Like, years later. So that's like, I'm playing against people who might be in a tournament and stuff. So I'm still winning most of the time. And like, where I'm at is that like, what you really have to pay attention to and why I might be the best is that number right there, 42. So that's like more like, that means that Dan is more like Daigo Umehara. I might be more like Daigo Umehara. Out of the looks too, right? There's nothing wrong with having the looks too, right? So, I've been, look, girls in Australia, you can see, like a lot of them Irish, all right? I like to fight too, all right? So I'm attractive to girls too, all right? What I'm saying is that girls in Australia have those big eyes too. All right, so like if I had a daughter, she'd be pretty hot, dude. Like, and like that's how I look at it. And so basically what I'm saying is that like, even if girls are incapable of being rapey, which I disagree with, I think that everyone's capable of being rapey because everyone has sexual urges, dude. So like, I think absolutely girls, and then girls like can't, they're not as good at like processing that they're being rapey. They don't think it's possible for them to, like, no, if you're basically intruding upon someone's sexuality in a way that makes them uncomfortable, it does, like, genitalia ceases to exist. Genitalia ceases to exist. Even Prague would agree that it's possible to intrude upon someone sexually. Even if it's, like, it's a vibe, dude. Too, I have the sixth sense, in these games, too. I have a sixth sense, all right? I have a sixth sense when it feels like someone's watching me, dude. So, like, I can feel the prying eyes, and a lot of them are females. Like, a lot of the prying eyes are females. They think that it's, like, they're somehow being, like, politically active by molesting me. Molesting me is, like, the right thing to do. Like, kind of, like, because I'm a bad person. And so, like, molesting me, regardless of, like, you know, what my peers may think of me within FGZ, like, it matters not that I am a decent player. What matters is that their subjective insults are to, like, justify the fact that, like, if I say that this is uncomfortable for me sexually, that matters not. Because, like, their opinion of what's comfortable for me sexually is paramount over my opinion of what's comfortable for me sexually because of their genitalia. Which kind of, like, just isn't... I don't really like that in terms of... And I would cite this as an argument, like, I would go for. Like, see, I go for, like, really good moves in these games, right? But I would cite that as an argument. It's like, now I don't really like how that lines up with your viewpoint on trans. Because trans is basically the idea is that genitalia doesn't necessarily decide your gender. So, like, to say, it's not because of my genitalia. So what is it? Why is it? Exactly. What if I disagree? What if you could possibly, well, and even then, Me Too kind of takes precedence over accusations of racism. What? Because accusations of racism could be more up to debate, whereas Me Too is less up to debate. Right? Me Too more that you've been straight up molested. Or like, you know, you have been straight up sexually violated. All right. And that there could be evidence of this. All right? Like in my case. All right. Whereas the accusations of racism are less tangible. Like, that's a little bit more a matter of perspective. Okay. Like, for example, I don't think it's okay to say that, like, just because someone's white, that they can't fight. For example, like, that they would lose the fight probably because of the color of their skin. But what about that person? Maybe that person's been in a lot of fights. Like, maybe that person's won a lot of fights. Like, regardless of the color of their skin. So, So I believe that's a racist accusation, for example. So that is like a specific example of being racist against a white guy. Like, I'm really good at fighting. I love fighting. And the thing is, I actually like to fight. Like, even if I lose, like, as you can see, I don't win every time in the game, you know. So I'm happy to lose. All right. So it's discriminatory for you to say that I'm probably going to lose because of the color of my skin. But what about my strategy in the fight? Like, what about the options that like these fighting games, like, what if I'm just going for more practical moves to win the fight than the opponent, regardless of their color, the color? Like, what if it's a, let's say it's a Mexican guy who is his first time fighting, and he wants to basically like just punch me in the face really hard. Well, good luck, right? So if he goes for a right hook, I mean, he's gonna hit arm. I'm not gonna go for a jab, like, you know, I'm not gonna stop blocking. So there's no right hook there, all right? So that right off the bat, regardless of the color of my skin, there's no right hook there, okay, for example. And then maybe I have a straight right hand too, that like, and if he's not blocking, then there might be a straight right hand there for me, and that might not feel good. That can knock your teeth back, okay? You could lose teeth on that, absolutely. That's why we use mouth guards, okay? So, dude, if we didn't use mouth guards, everyone would be like Brent Burns, you know what I mean? So, Brent Burns has lost a few teeth, but it's like he actually likes that, you know, like, that's how he fucks with it. Like, and he still eats pizza and stuff. So then beyond that, like, what if that person doesn't know how to do a takedown, right? And what if that person can't defend a takedown? Like, so what if now I decide to grab his leg, and then there's not really, and my head's kind of close to him, so there's not really, like, I have a chin too, so there's not really, like, in my last fight when I took, like, a lot of blunt force trauma to the head. So, like, what if there's not really, there's no, like, my head's, like, kind of more, like, where, kind of more, like, here, right? So, I'm ready to defend a guillotine, too, if I have to, right? Like, they'll put you in the guillotine, like, ultimately, you want to land on top and then get your hand in the guillotine, okay? So, they can do that until you're blue in the face, right? But then you pull your fucking head out of their guillotine, and now you're on top. Now you can kind of just start, like, I'm a pretty big dude too, like exactly. And here's what my friend Kevin Valencia, like, we were gonna fight, and now he would just basically have to embrace that he can do a takedown too, like, right? And he has elbows too, all right, right? So basically, then it becomes more like poker a little bit, and then ultimately, if you land up, like, you just want to end a fight fast, like, so if you do get on top, you want to crack, and you get the chance to crack them with an elbow strike, then crack them and crack their knees too, right? And then crack their knees and then get up even. And then they're stuck on the ground, right? And then they look like a clown. And then you can just walk away. You don't have to even hurt them any more than that, right? If you take their knees, right? This is one thing that you're probably not allowed to do in the UFC. Like, because I actually elbowed my knee just slightly one time. And it hurt hella bad. It bruised hella bad. And then I just kind of, not even full force, right? Just like, and, like, again, guys, those are sharp as fuck. I'm strong as fuck, too. All right, I'm 6'2". That's a really sharp elbow. It's like concrete, too. Baseball bats, all right? That shit's sharp. Okay. That's, it's concrete, too. Okay. All right, I have a good rotator, like, kind of like torque on that too. All right, so if you get cracked like on the ground, good night, basically. Like, that could be one and done. All right, so I mean, understand that fighting is all about physiology, and so I recognize that if I am on top and like there's an elbow strike available, and I go and I fucking crack you, that's gonna fucking crack you, dude. Like, dude. That's gonna, dude, that could kill you. Like, not, that's not, one is not gonna kill you. That could absolutely daze you. Okay, like, one could absolutely daze you. And then, you know, it's, and fucking, you see, did you hear that? That's not me breathing. That's literally air, dude. You hear that? All right. My elbows are from fucking hell. So, good fucking luck. That fight can go either way. I don't care who it is, right? That was air. You hear it one more time. Literally. That's a hammer, too. That's a baseball bat. So I know that that goes my way, and I know that I have a single leg trip takedown, inside hook, and Henry Cejudo. And I know I can get top position, and I'm long also. I'm long. So, like, I have a long torso. So maybe from full guard, that won't matter much, okay? So what I'm saying is that I can fight too. So that's why I'm always at the park. Because I'm pretty smart. Like, I'm just going to kind of do this, and I might not even throw one if I have to, if it's there, you know. But ultimately, I'm going to grab that single leg, and I have long legs. So that's what I'm saying. Like, I'll take you down. Like, right? Even if you're a wrestler. Like, I have long legs, okay? Fast limbs, too. I can get the inside hook quick. Okay? So when I go for the single leg, it's kind of going to be like one sweeping motion. And then even if it's kind of like an awkward takedown. And then you might be in full guard, but I'm long. And then if you're blocking your head, maybe I'll take your fucking knees, you know, like that fucking hurts either way. Okay. And then maybe you're blocking, right? Maybe there's a certain point where those forearms start breaking under the elbows. Okay. And then eventually it's just basically, you know, unless you have something to say about it, you know, like your legs have something to say about it, like a crane hook. Get your like. Okay, and another thing that this is why where you're gonna want to cry when you fight me. Okay, you'd rather die, right? You're winning up until you're losing. Okay, so it's like. Not a fun matchup for anyone. Even in MMA, I don't care if it's heavyweight. Like, it's not a fun fight for anyone. And so I don't care if it's Brock Lesnar. Like, I probably lose, sure. If it's Masvidal, I'll probably lose. But it's not going to be, like, a comfortable match for anyone. If it's bare knuckles, okay? If the rules are bare knuckles, all right? So this is why I'm telling you, the burden of proof is on you. Like, I'm always there. And so, the way these people play is unfair. And again, 42 game win streak, I'm smart too. Like I know I'm surfy with it too. So this is them. This is not Russ. This is not Hobson. This is not me and my friends. This is not a ranger. This is not how a ranger acts. Like, it's not how a knight acts, right? Not how a fighter acts. Not right. It's not how Brawley acts. You know, a Brawley plays, for example, right? So John Jones would respect Raleigh as much as I would, you know, because he plays. This is how people act when they don't play. It's a normal size container, up to him. Nothing he's saying is true. I would beat his bitch ass. Well, take his computer. I don't know what next. You know, basically, like, let's not listen to a word he's saying about me, too. You know, let's not listen to a word, you know. We can do no wrong. Even the girls, right? We can do no wrong. We have vaginas, right? So we can do no wrong because of the power of the vagina. We can't, Savannah's vagina is irrelevant in comparison to my vagina. You know, like, Daniel's genitals are relevant in comparison to my genitals. And then you have a boyfriend that you get to bang all the time. Right. How is that fucking fair? I'm actually more worried about the single girls. I'm more worried about the single girls that are not grasping the politics of this. Like, that this is not okay to do to anyone, let alone myself. All right. So basically, like, when someone starts streaming, they have consented for you to observe them, right? So I have gotten to a point where I've given consent to everyone all the time because people just disrespect the concept of consent anyway, right? because not everyone's on the same page when it comes to this, like, no means no and yes means yes business. All right. So, so beyond that, like, I'm happy to make this simu. I'm happy. I want to get involved. I want to participate in, like, the best way I can do that, the best thing, the way I know how so far is to do this Twitch stream. And also, like, when it comes to this self-defense stuff, like, don't take it from me. Take it from someone else, right? Like, go to KOA. If you're in 650, you can go to KOA in Mountain View and learn some Muay Thai. And, yeah, beyond that, like, look, my girlfriend's really good looking. She really turns me on, personally. She also turns a lot of guys on. So, she's also very much a target, right? She's like a, she's desirable, right? So her looks are like a trigger, right? She triggers people, like, sexually. So that would happen even if it's like an image of her over the computer still looks like her, right? It still sets off a trigger. And so this is not okay. And there's no rationalization for something like that, because that rationalization could be used by a sociopath to get any ass. All right. So now you're racist and you're crazy. And if you say that you're not racist and you're not crazy, well, I disagree, because I'm entitled to your opinion. And now that I'm entitled to your opinion, this is moral. It's actually the morally right thing to do would be to rape and murder you. To rape you or let you become suicidal because you're getting molested constantly. And there's not a goddamn thing you can do about it. That's why we have hashtag Ravine, we have hashtag Me Too. And this is what Me Too looks like, you know? That basically, a lot of people are behind us and fucking love you all. All right. This is what we need to do. We need to snowball, okay? So it's okay if you ever made a mistake, and it's okay if your opinions, like, my opinions on politics changed hella. Like, I used to believe more so in a more free market, not like free market, like, I was leaning less, I'm leaning a lot less towards, like, the concept of, like, a fair marketplace, like the marketplace, when you actually just take a step back and think about it for a second. Well, if you have more money, you can buy the computer store. If you have more money, you can, and they've set up the IKEA in the Red Line community, and you want there to be a high, upper class, middle class, lower class, right? Well, now that we have finally set up the IKEA, because someone did the right thing, now someone else bought, like, the whole block that the IKEA was on. And it, like, forces that the IKEA, for some law, there's some law where it's like now they also bought some law where, like, or some shit, right? Where now it's like the IKEA, because, like, part of the IKEA was in, like, the lot or something, right? And then it's like, it's shit like that, you know? And then it's like, and then ultimately the IKEA gets, like, totaled, like, because, like, they can't, like, really, it just becomes, like, unethical to even, like, go, like, they were going to put the IKEA there, but now because the other person bought out the whole block, it just becomes, like, it's not no longer feasible to put the IKEA there. And then when you raise issue with that, they don't want to hear it. They don't care. So when you have money, you have laws, and when you have laws, you have money. So, basically the way they play is like, but the problem here is that, the court of public opinion is really matters a lot too, because their names are on the line, their reputations are on the line. And a lot of people are going to have to be their, like, sacrificial lambs, you know? So, we should hold them to that. Like, no, I'm not inciting violence, but I am inciting, like, hold these people to the point. Like, if you are able to communicate with them, like, hold them to the point. And even record the conversation. Like, record the fucking conversation. Absolutely. Record the fucking conversations. That's like I do with Rissman. Like, what I learned from Ross. Like, record the fucking conversation, and then maybe even post it on the fucking internet. Like, you know, like, the conversation with Rissman was insane. Like, are we gonna uphold doctor-patient confidentiality? No. And they also bought psychiatry. They bought psychiatry. They own psychiatry. They own anthropology. They own sociology. They own, you know, they own the museums. They, like, right? Like, the people who have the most wealth, it's like Monopoly, Snowball. So you can own everything. So and then they hoard the wealth. So we can't get to the wealth, okay? Because of, like, Wells Fargo and shit. So because they own the banks. And they own the banks in the third world countries, too. Because, like, they snowballed globally, right? Because there's an exchange rate, and you can, your money can be exchanged into currency in every country, basically. And so that's why we have paper currency in every country. It's not, like, uncut gems in one country. It's, like, paper currency, same bank, basically all the same bank, right? And so then, despite what you may think, it's, like, they can exchange that money, that U.S. dollar can be exchanged into, like, a Nigerian dollar, right? And so they own, so now you can see why it's the same fucking people who have like a stranglehold over the whole world. Like, it's less so, and then they use the mainstream media to make it seem more it's like America versus China, when in reality it's just who has the most money, because then they can that American money can be legally converted into Chinese money. Okay, so why the fuck wouldn't that person have influence in China at that point? Because that person can now buy out places in China too. That person can now buy the IKEA in China. That person can now buy the IKEA in India. And they hoard the wealth. That's why we see, as a commonly known fact, that, like, a very small percentage of the population owns a very large percentage of the wealth. Okay, that is not what we want. Because now, like, basically since, like, if you're in a redline community in the United States, for example, and you don't have enough money to, like, you have so little money, it's not even funny. Now you have to steal shit, all right? Because that's why we're going to see higher crime rates in those areas. So you have to steal shit now. And then you get a felony. You know, like, and then the system sets it up so it's hard. You're on probation. All right. But you still don't have shit. All right. So you have to steal something again. And then, you know, whatever. Right? Like, and also personality type that's in that scenario too. Like, what's what I'm saying about, there are different, gene pools too. All right, so for me as well, right? Like I was like, this is fucking dumb, and I'm gonna go steal that shit, like basically. And I did get arrested for that. And then I started playing more clean, and now I'm sober, right? And I have food, right? And I'm completely sober. I mean, I'm drinking Mountain Dew. I have enough money to buy some Mountain Dew, right? But yeah, this is what we're dealing with. And then we have, I guess, like, I'll just get in the habit of playing this a lot, okay? And so based off that concept of, like, the economy and stuff, and why we can't really, does it seem like we've really made much headway? Like, I mean, EPA is a lot better. We have an IKEA and EPA, though. You know, like, we don't really have an IKEA. Like, shouldn't we invest into the redline communities? Like, why not? With all of the government funding, you know, like, why haven't we really just fucking invested into the red, like just truly invested, not in a way that's, like, drops in the bucket? Like, why not even just fucking give them handouts? Like, with government, like, we have $64 million a day going to NASA to not put a woman on the moon. So why don't we just cut the funding to NASA entirely? Because I would put people out of work. Well, those are, like, more, like, upper class, middle class people. Like, and they can totally get another fucking job, in my opinion. So, like, I'm just saying, this is a practical solution. Now we have $64 million a day going straight into the fucking redline communities. And then we have SpaceX, too. So, fuck off. Like, NASA can fuck off. Like, they're misogynistic. They're too misogynistic. They're not putting a woman on the moon. They haven't even addressed that, probably. So let's go ahead and take that $64 million a day that's going to NASA. And we could do this, right? But no, we can't, because of, like, Parliament and, like, the Supreme Court and, like, executive privilege. And when the president does it, it's not legal. Okay, like, so fuck that. Maybe we need to, like, I don't know. Like, this could get super ghetto. Like, basically, like, if they're going to be this ridiculous. Okay, like, understand. Ali said the same shit. It's like, it's the fucking U.S. government, right? Like, but what is the U.S. government, right? It's like, there are different branches and stuff, but ultimately, there is Like, let's watch this video right now, too. Like, oh, what's up, Aldo? Okay. And also, it seems like you can basically buy people. If you have money, you can also buy people. Like, in what, that's why I can't see Savannah. Because of, like, laws, or, the fuck if I know. You know, like, whatever the fuck they did, you know. I mean, they fucked the life of a bunch of kids. And they're raping us, too. You know, sure. Like, they're sadistic. So they, like, if you're a good person, like, we're really trying to do the right thing. So, like, and it's simple shit. That's what I'm saying. Tell you guys. Oh, that's what's going down. All right, cool.
Turning off the cube layer, you see the rectangle surrounding the White House is also made up of a pair of interlocking triangles. This is not calm. He sees the following diagram on the streets and interconnection of monuments.
So, I mean, the blueprint for, like, if you're laying out an infrastructure, you're going to do it, like, practically, right? So, I mean, and then they're going to get creative with it, too. So they'll put, like, symbols, too. Like, these micro-beings are
the microcosm, which is everything in the universe, human scale or smaller.
If you have a macro penis, don't, like, you can also eat a girl out, so fuck off.
We'll be running into all over the world. I found a pair of 3, 4, 5 triangles between the cube and the pyramid. Turning off the cube layer,
and how about surrounding the white feelings and, like, crushing on people and, like,
pair of interlocking triangles.
You know what I mean? Like, that counts for something.
5, 12, 13 proportions.
Like, looks are like the icing on the cake, kind of, like.
5, 12, 13. Are the first two Pythagorean triplets. As you'll begin to appreciate,
like, everyone's a human being, dude. Like, people, like, are evil, man. Like, Mia, Mia's really funny.
On the back of the dollar bill, of course. If we illuminate the DC pyramid with the same all-seeing
like,
eye of
having sex is not, like,
directed to a specific
anything
building.
Out of the ordinary. And if you're, if
is
it's filmed,
the
then that's
looking at?
Fine, do. Like, both people have consented. Like,
either way, what is
I bet a lot of people do porn just because, like, look, well, they're, like, spying on, like, they're like,
of Scottish Freemasonry,
you know,
which goes by many
creeping
names,
on me anyway, so fuck it.
Council, Mother Council of the World, and House of the Temple.
That's why I became, that's why I, where I got into being in porn, it's like, kind of like,
with a 13-step unfinished pyramid on top. Just like on the dollar
it was like forced
bill,
upon me.
And two giant sphinxes flank the entrance out front. The architect John Russell Pope modeled the 1911
building. A lot of people are bisexual, dude. Like,
Manassas,
they want to fuck both me and Savannah.
Built into the architecture of the universe.
So, as you can see, here, here's the point. Is that, like,
is this the Eye of Providence we are looking at?
Look, it's not the Illuminati. It's called Freemasonry.
The same, all-seeing
so,
eye. If we illuminate
here.
The DC pyramid with the same all-seeing Eye of Providence, we are...
It's the important thing. The White House is right here. All right. The White House right here. These are landmarks. You can see Jefferson Memorial. All right. You can see U.S. Navy. U.S. Navy Memorial. You can see the U.S. Department of State. Right, so they're lining up really well, you know. Washington Circle, you have Mount Vernon Square over here. You have Scott Circle over here. Now you have the White House kind of in the middle, right? So the White House has some power, I guess. Like, because the caste system.
Three,
you know,
four,
the
five,
few ruling the many.
Five, with the same all-seeing eye of providence.
So right in the people, what do we have?
Specific building. is this the Eye of Providence we are looking at? Or it's older in
Have you ever watched Yu-Gi-Oh? Is this Egyptian course. Symbolism just like
either
the
way,
pyramid?
What is behind the all-seeing eye of the
It has
sun.
To do with, like, the Bible and shit, too. And they'll make it like, oh, it's the Illuminati.
Which goes by many names, including the Supreme Council.
It's free. It's the Freemason building.
It's the headquarters of Scottish Freemasonry, which goes by many names, including the Supreme Council, Mother Council of the World, and House of the Temple.
I mean, probably, like, there's more to this than I can ever ascertain. But, like,
three vertebrae. Count,
but I mean, like, what we can look at is this is the key, because, like, controlling the money is to
might very well be
control the world.
The architecture of the universe. For further confirmation,
so this is the key, guys.
The Great Seal of the United States of America is shown on the back.
And again, I'm really good at the game. Again, like, I'm really good. Like, so it's not fair.
That's the side with the eagle.
They can't beat me.
Most important to
so the argument ends at the fight. I quote John Jones, the argument ends at the fight. The argument ends at the competition. But they don't really even seem to have to compete. Like, it's not my opponent. It's not like my friends in the FGC that are the problem.
32 overtones just discussed in relation to the Schumann resonance.
This is how Knights Templar started in the first place. Freemasonry is Knights Templar. Which is probably just the same shit, actually.
Three circles with their centers on each other's circumferences.
Like, why aren't we getting paid? Why is it the kingdom is getting the drawbridge, dude? That gap between the top triangle and the rest of the triangle is a drawbridge, basically. They're kings.
A Star of David emerges.
Hebrew, too.
Three circles intersection points. Examining the reverse of the Great Seal, we find the same controlling geometry. Look at the letters picked out of the mottos Anuit Coptis and Novus Ordo Seclorum. Never mind right now what these mottos signify. The letters at the points of the Star of David are A, S, N, O, and M. Rearranging, we get Mason.
All right, why do I have this always on my stream? Oh, excuse me. It always says Mason. And then, again, I'll continue to do this, like almost systematically. It's chain. Like, Scorpion Chin to watch that video. And then the altar is a double key. And please cross compare this with the logic where it's like, okay, if you can exchange money between countries, then now you have the most money in one country. Well, you have the most money in all the countries, right? So maybe the people, maybe it's like they're rich people that are just rich people in all the countries. So if you're rich in one country, you're rich in every country because there's an exchange rate, right? So if you're rich in one country, you're rich in every country. Okay, understand, really, please grasp that concept. All right. And they print the money, the Masons print the money in the U.S. at least. So if you, like, so if you're rich in the U.S., like, this is what I'm saying is that, like, maybe that, like, that place in the pupil, maybe that is what we're looking out for. And you see how they're always, like, it'll be, like, Ed Sheeran, like, and shit like that. It's like, Or Taco Bell, it's like an I. Or, you know what I mean? Or McDonald's is an M. Yeah. Okay. It's basically like this smoke screen. I'll play a song. I will play a song for you guys. Right. The altar is a double cube, pure white, and bearing on its west side the initials of the three GMs, and below them the double T. The top of the altar should be fitted with a square plate of gold bearing a circle and a triangle of the same metal. The apex of the triangle, and again, really fast. My bad, sorry. This compilation is the property of the Supreme Grand Chapter of Royal Arch Freemasons of Victoria. It's Victoria, Australia. It's like Melbourne, Australia. It is issued by the Grand Scribe E only, and also Melbourne's, if you're going to Australia, Melbourne's cool for like bar scene and like kind of hanging out and music scene. Well, Melbourne and Sydney both, but. And Sydney's cool for the nightlife. So if you're looking for the nightlife, you go to Sydney. And if you're looking for, like, the bar scene, you go to Melbourne. All right. And no other person is... And go to Luna Park if you go there, too. It's the same... It's the same makers of, like, Coney Island and shit. And no... And Melbourne's, like, on the coast. It's basically on the east coast of Australia. It's surfy. It's actually a lot like California. All right. And no other person is authorized... to print or publish the same or any part thereof, issued on express condition that it is not to be used in this chapter. And here's the signature. Oops. Basically, my grandfather and the grandfather before him were both Masons. All right, so the W on the triangle should be arranged to read opposite to the direction in which the hands of a clock move. Thanks, Carlton. And the top of each letter being toward the center of the triangle. The W on the circle is read in the same direction as the face of a clock. They're so smart, right? The bottom of each letter being towards the center. The first part is placed on the E, and I am Hebrew, but like opposite the apex of the triangle. And the two remaining parts opposite the two other angles. The three Hebrew characters are to be placed within the angles of the triangle. The Aleph in the E, the Beth in the NW, and the Lamed in the SW. The altar must be provided with a cover of convenient size and made of white satin fringed with crimson and tasseled with gold. The characters on the top of the altar should be arranged immediately before the opening of the chapter and concealed by the cover. Okay, so interestingly enough, clearly we have this Star of David, we have this Hebrew thing with Freemasonry, but we also have like a Christian Bible in which like we like inaugurate the president, right? We have a Christian Bible within Freemasonry as well. So basically it's like Christian and Hebrew, okay? It's a point I want to make out. And then, Savannah. And then, and so, beyond that, guys. Oh, yeah, I guess I'll play a song for you really fast. Nah, that's what I do. Do I have a... And like again, you guys, I sacrificed a lot about this, and a lot of it had to do with listening to, watching the news with a Jamaican guy, watching an episode of Joe Rogan, Drod, and ultimately watching the news with a Jamaican guy. Oh yeah, okay, right. I didn't even like. Okay, I wasn't even trying to say that they're both black, but okay. See if we have a tuner on the, like, you know, online tuner. Okay. Tuner. Oh, did we get a tuner app? So this is steel string. They stole my Takamina. They stole my fucking computer. They not only do they want to have all the money, they want you to have like less money and stuff. They want all the wealth and they want you to have less wealth. Turn on the tuner. Okay, we have turned on the tuner. Like tuning is hella simple, and then when you can change the tuning by just like if you tune one down, like see how it's like B2, C3, just tune them all down the same amount or up the same amount, right? So we want B2 now. Or I guess, like. Or maybe. Actually. I like, look, I have never seen one that's this weird. Okay. Okay. Oh, here we go. Oh, this is perfect. All right. So we want, oh yeah, I forgot, I have a tuner on my phone. The phones are really good for tuning too. Like, guitar is actually, like, it's pretty easy, guys. Like, it's pretty simple. Like, if you're in the music industry, like, you're kind of more in, like, rap and hip hop, fuck with the guitar too. Like, you have, there's enough time in the day, it's not that hard. Like, it's kind of where the meta is going to, like, everyone's doing everything. Like, I just use the other guitar because of Oregon. Like, basically, like, I like to tune it down a little bit. But, I'm just gonna say fuck it right now. Like, I need, like, the right tuner. I'm, like, not that good at tuning, like, by ear. I usually have, like, a snark, which is really cool, but I can't find it right now. It'll turn out while as I clean my room more. Song's called They Live. Have you seen the John Carpenter movie, They Live? And doesn't it seem like the kind of shit they'd do? Okay. I'm a big fan of Greaves, by the way. That dude's great.
Away, broadcast the deception. They live through the airwaves and cell phone reception. We channels of all day. They flood every station, church and state all the same. Kingdom of the Mason. Kingdom of the Mason. We're the children of men, built our houses on Elm Street in the devil's playpen. With eyes wide shut we sleep, a dead light overhead that shines like a beacon. Now we wake up to stare.
Sorry.
Now we wake up to stare down the eye of the demon. The eye of the demon. So I'll send this final transmission. They live to deceive us. Just pray and someone will listen. It's time to wake up. The great puppet show, Masters of distraction, they live through the shadows. Dancing dolls keep us laughing while the phantom remains. Haunting this delusion, face the master mason, author of illusion. Author of illusion. I bless you now with eyes to see, a looking glass straight through the lies they preach. It's all a dream. Take a trip down the rabbit hole with me, or you could leave. Go ahead, close your eyes, go back to sleep. So blissfully, go return to your normal fantasy. Fantasy. Fantasy.
I used to be able to hit that. Then I blew out my vocal. Because people are ridiculous. Okay. Because they're 10. The people I'm talking about are 10 years old.
Fantasy. Fantasy.
Kind of made like Legend of Zelda, you know, like, you know what I mean, like.
The watchers of the globe, the land of the fallen, as above, so below. Simple inversion of knowledge, a dead light overhead that shines like a beacon. Now together we stare down the eye of the demon. The eye of the demon. So I'll send this final transmission. They live to divide us. Meanwhile, our children lie sleeping. It's time to wake up. One final transmission to lift this hypnosis. One last chance to appeal to the best in us. It's time to wake up. It's time to wake up. Time to wake up.
For sure. I'm actually turning the bag and break. I was more happy with that one than last time around. Well, okay, so basically for me, it's really frustrating because I do need to hit those, like, I literally just can't fucking do it anymore, man. I'm Steve-O now. They turned me. They, like, waved their fucking magic wand of Gryffindor. Like, and turned me. Like, they waved their, like, dick around and turned me into Steve-O. Alright? They're complete pussies, dude. Like, they don't play. But I'm talking about with Russ and, like, Hobson and my friends, too, that I play music with as well. They play. You know, it's like, you don't have to be fist fighting, you don't have to be playing Street Fighter necessarily, like, but, like, you don't have to be playing chess necessarily, you don't have to be singing necessarily, you don't have to be in Cirque du Soleil necessarily. We have to be doing something. You know, like, you play music, it's cool too. Alright, like Russ plays. Russ is at the table, that's what I'm telling you guys. Like, and the Twitch stream is a great way to get to the table if you haven't, and then instead of talking shit about me without doing shit about it, like, why don't, and even if you disagree with me, why don't you fucking make a video? Why don't you actually do something about it? Like you're stifling this thing. Like, I can feel your peering eyes, and I can feel your negative vibes, and you just have to realize, all right? You just have to realize.